ghanamusic.com. Kwao Kese. One on one. Live. You know, GH Music. That's what's up. Minimalizia. I'm releasing a lot of singles, you know. I'm working on my US album, Forever, with Coptic, Grammy producer, you know. And at the same time working on the Mad Timers with Brakwebu and Buddha. Also Shoot to Kill, my 26 track album. You know. So it's work, you know. And you know, when I say US album, I mean, you know, album that is mainly recorded, you know, in the US. You know, so like all the tracks on the album, like 95% of the songs on the album Forever was produced, you know, in the US. That's what I mean by my US album. Anyway, it will be released on the US market. So that's what I mean by, you know, my US album. Some of the songs on the album are out, you know, songs like Ain't Gonna Let This Go, you know, featuring Real Gaddis, you know, which is making a lot of impact on YouTube, you know. You know, so that's what it is. And I have a couple of others that have been released recently that is in the line of promotion. Simply means hit your target, you know. You know, it's the bullet is expensive, so don't just miss a bullet like that. You know, try to hit your target. That's what I mean by shoot to kill. Yeah, one cabia, yeah, you fear, and Obepra, made the Obepra. It's not about, you know, killing people in the industry. You know, it's a general thing, you know, compare it to life, you know. If you go to school, shoot to kill, you know, come back successful or don't go at all. You know, if you're a footballer, you know, when you go to the field, shoot to kill, you know, which means go for success. You know, doing anything for success is shooting to kill, and that's what I'm doing. You know, I'm hitting my target. I have a lot of songs that I record day in and day out, and you know, I think I can't be keeping the songs to myself, so I have to share them out. And these are songs that I record every day, you know, like every day I make a song, and I feel like, Charlie, I keep the songs I pile them too much, I for share them, make people feel what is cooking, you know, in the madman's kitchen. Describe my music, you know, I would say my music is a street music, you know. I do controversial music, you know, because I want to say things that the ordinary people are scared of saying, you know. So that goes on the street to be a street music, so I do street music. That's what's up. I do rap, I do hip hop, I do hip life, and I do street music. Yeah. You know, I always choose the titles of my song after the song is done, you know. So that's how come the deep, you know, the deeper the titles, you know. I don't just wake up and say today I'ma, and go to studio and rap about I'ma. You know, the beat has to speak and tell me what the title of the song should be. The lyrics plays important role. You know, the instrumentation. You know, before the title. Date is not yet set for the album drop, Shoot to Kill album drop, but we're still working, and I have about 5 singles released out there already. The likes of Flair Flair, you know, CD All Eyes on Me, you know, Insanity with Nice, you know, I'm Free with Brymo. You know, a lot of songs have been released on the Street to Kill album, and it's a 26 album in the making, so 26 track album, just watch out. I recorded an album, you know, a couple of years ago, and I didn't release it because I was always, you know, adjourning the date and, you know, the time to release it. You know, I felt like Charlie is a waste of energy and waste of songs. So this time, you know, I've taken it upon myself that hey, in a year I can record about 50 songs. So why don't I put, you know, things out so that people can just get it? And that's why I'm putting 26 tracks on an album. You know, it means I've recorded a lot of songs and I have to, you know, release them out. When we talk about airplay, you know, I would say I'm the artist who don't get that much airplay that like the other artists. You know, it's not easy to hear my music. I don't know, you know, why the DJs and the presenters don't play my music that much like how they do to the artists. One thing also is that most of the presenters and DJs are managers of some artists. So when they come on the radio, they prefer playing songs from their artists, you know, and that is something I don't really get it, and I don't really get this from Ghana. You know, an artist who presents a show comes on his show, and all he does is plays his song. You know, a presenter comes and plays his artist, an artist that he manages. He plays his songs. And, you know, this conflict of interest is not, you know, helping the Ghana music industry. And, you know, that's how come they don't play my music. But hey, I don't care. You know, the streets in any way, in whatever way they can do to get my music. That's why Flair Flair was never played, and it's never been played on radio. But it's a banger. It's one big song. You know, thanks to, you know, social media and the internet, you know, we are working. Thanks to some of you people who are doing good work, you know, like GhanaMusic.com, spreading our music out there. I don't see any sense in paying Payola. You know, if you are doing a good work for me and I like you and I feel what your hustle, I can dash you something from my heart. But for you to expect me to pay you before you play my music, you know, you work. And at the end of the month, you get paid. And the same way, you know, your work is to play my music and play the good songs out there. So if you come and you say, I haven't paid you, so you won't play, then massa, you know, crazy. Stage people ask me a lot of questions about this. What do I do? Where do I get the energy and all that from? You know, I am somebody who is into psychology, you know. So, you know, before I come on stage, you know, first let me say most of my stage performances are freestyle, you know, are freestyle performances. You know, some of them too, we really spend time to plan, spend money to get it on point. You know, but anytime I'm on the stage, you know, I have to study the psyche of the people, you know, where their minds want to go, and I take them there. You know, that's the psychology, you know, psychological part or the psychological side of myself. You know, if I psych the people up and I see that they want to go here, then I make them go here. If they want to go then I make them go and you know. Bob Marley, you know, Bob Marley left a legacy, you know, for reggae. You know, I would say Tupac did the same, Biggie did the same for hip hop. You know, I'm leaving a legacy, and I will leave this legacy as the best, you know, performer Ghana has ever seen. You know, come out of Ghana. That's the legacy, you know, killing every show. The guy who came and killed every show from day one till. That's the legacy, you know, and people have already been talking about it, and they will always talk about it